But it was time for him to go to the battlefield
and fight courageously.
He gathers the family members, starts to bid farewell to them one by one. And he looked, and there was one daughter of his, Sukaina, who was sitting in the corner of the tent. She looked up and said, "Oh, my father, is it true that I will be an orphan?" He said, "Oh, my dear daughter, bear this and be patient, for God the Almighty will reward you and will take you out of this difficult position." She said, "Oh, my father, if is this the case, then place your hands on my head, just the way the orphans are treated." Hussein ibn Ali has now bidden his farewell to his family members and goes towards the battlefield.
Then he looks towards his steed and spurs his steed and says, "Oh steed, take your master to his final battle."
He calls out, "Oh godless enemies of Allah."
He fights them and engages them in battle. Do you know what blood you have
spilled?
Do
you know how you have violated the sanctity of the Messenger of Allah?
When Umar ibn Sa'd saw that this was not working, he began saying to them, "Attack him in multitudes." Large numbers of people, they surrounded Hussein like locusts. Everyone kept fighting Hussein from all sides. Hussein kept fighting.
Hussein can no longer maintain himself upon the back of the steed as he begins to descend upon the earth of Karbala.
He extracts the arrows from his body, stands and engages the enemy. Says, "By Allah, you will never again fight one like me." Abu Abdullah fights them to a great extent. Abu Abdullah trembled as he supplicated. He said, "Oh Lord, endurance upon your decree, acceptance of your final command. Oh Lord, you are my only Lord, the one I rely on every affair. No one other than you is worthy of worship." We are told stones are being thrown at him. Arrows are fired at him. The enemies surround him and mock at him. When Abu Abdullah falls to the ground, they all retreat, not knowing his fate. Abu Abdullah is still breathing. As the final moments of Abu Abdullah approach, as the army closes in on Abu Abdullah, Abu Abdullah's lips begin to move in the praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The enemies called out, "By Allah, we have not seen a man so deprived, so helpless, so hungry, so thirsty, so wounded, about to die, but his face radiates," as Abu Abdullah's face radiates, "with serenity and eulogizing Allah." Shimmer advances towards Abu Abdullah. Abu Abdullah barely finds himself into sajda. Shimmer grabs the hair of Imam Hussein from the back and flings him upon his back. He placed his knee on the chest of Hussein.
In another hadith, Jibreel alayhi salam. salam, he said, your community will kill this son of yours. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam replied, they will kill him while believing in me? And he said, yes. And then Jibreel brought forth soil and said, from such and such a place. Ali radiallahu anhu, he said, I entered upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam one day and his eyes were pouring forth tears. I said, Messenger of God, has someone angered and upset you? What is the matter that your eyes weep? He sallallahu alayhi wasallam replied, rather, Jibreel stood with me before me and informed me that Hussein would be killed by the banks of the Euphrates. When he stands at that place, there are individuals who dare to even think of harming a hair of the grandson of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. A young boy who upon his birth, the Prophet made the aqiqah for him. He called the adhan in his ears. He did the tahniq, he put his blessed saliva into the mouth of his grandson. He gave him his name,